titles going to China. China, of course, are guaranteed a third title here, because the mixed doubles is an all-Chinese affair. It is a repeat of the Olympic final. And what dominance in this discipline by China at the quarterfinal stage. As you can see, four Chinese pairs, one Thailand pair, one Dane, one Indonesian and one Hong Kong pair. But by semi-finals, it was three Chinese pairs and the Olympic bronze medalists and home favourites, Joachim Fischer and Christina Pedersen. Well, they were quite simply outclassed in the semi-final against Zhu Chen and Ma Jin. So for Zhu Chen and Ma Jin, this is their second consecutive World Championship final, and they're up against the former world champions and current Olympic champions, Chen Nan and Zhao Yunlei. So four pairs at quarterfinals from China. Morton, that's a fairly emphatic statement by China Badminton.
Yes, absolutely. It's awesome. They have a good team, as always. And so often, as we say, is China against the rest of the world.
Yeah. So here come the silver medalists from last year's World Championships. Silver medalists having had two match point opportunities for gold. Their opponents, the 2011 world champions and current Olympic champions, can Zhao Yunlei win a second gold medal at these world championships? She's guaranteed an eighth medal at world championships. And can she become only the eighth player in history to win two world championship medals at the same world championship? Of course, one player has done that twice. The great Park Jibong. Men's doubles and mixed doubles in the same world championships achieved twice. That is extraordinary. That was in 1985 in Calgary and in 1991 here in Copenhagen. So as with the men's singles, this is the number one and two seeds contesting the final. So both the women on court have been former world champions, but this is Zhang Nan, 24-year-old born in Beijing. He and his partner, as you can see from their win-loss record for the year, they've been in three finals from six tournaments. The only blip was a first-round loss at the Indonesia Super Series. And their only blip here was three games in their first match, which was the second round against Chen Hongling and Chen Wen-Sing from Chinese Taipei. Since then, they've been in great form. Zhao Yunlei turned 28 on the first day of these World Championships last Monday. So to Zhu Chen, 29 years of age. Partner, the number two seeds, but now number three in the world ranking, and of course the number two pair in the world ranking, sadly not able to defend their title, the Indonesians Tantowi Pakanan and Liliana Nasir. Now, how impressive is that? All of their matches in two straight games, including that semi-final against the number three seeds and Olympic bronze medalists Joachim Fischer-Nielsen and Christina Pedersen. 21-15, 21-9 in the second. I thought that would be a very close match, but it turned out to be very one-sided, and all because of the very, very good play from Zhu Chen and Ma Jin. Jakob Sindberg from Denmark, is our umpire for this, Christoph Oswald from Germany, the service judge. And this will be the 19th meeting between these two pairs. And the previous 18 occasions, the Olympic champions have won 16 of those last 18, including the last, which was the semi-final of the All England Championships in March. That match wasn't completed.
On my right,
as you can see, Jin Ma retiring injured partway through that second game. So the number one seeds and Olympic champions, Jiang Nan and Zhao Yunlei, nearest to us against last year's beaten finalists Xu Chen and Ma Jin. Now, Morton, I made a comment that with four Chinese pairs in the quarterfinal stage, that China was making an emphatic statement about the mixed doubles. But it's interesting that since China first played the World Championships, became part of the international governing body, their first World Championships were here in Copenhagen in 1983. They've only won gold in the mixed doubles five times. This, obviously, they will win gold again, which yes, pair we're not sure, will only be the sixth time. And this is only the second all-Chinese mixed doubles final.
That's
a surprise.
Surprising statistics. Very much. I would have thought they had done better.
Yeah. Well, the only previous time that it was an all-Chinese mixed doubles final was in Paris in 2010, when Ma Jin, one of the players on court, won the gold medal with Zheng Bo, and they beat He Hanbin and Yu Yang, who we saw in the women's doubles final in that final 4 years ago. Now, the problem for the silver medalists from both the Olympic Games and last year's World Championships is, more than anything, psychological, I guess, Morton.
Yeah, I'm speechless that they won 16 out of 18.
Yeah.
That is beyond it, because I think that Ma Jin and Xu Chen is a very good pair. And, you know, when they play their teammates, you know, I would have thought, let's say, 12-6, 11-7, something like that.
Yeah.
But 16-2.
And one of those two victories for Xu Chen Ma Jin was when their opponents retired injured.
That makes it even worse, doesn't it?
Yeah, so they've actually only won.
One.
Now, you were talking in the men's singles, Morton, about the psychology of, you know, whether you suit another pair's style of play and
yes,
so on. It's quite obvious to me that, you know, I don't doubt Xu Chen and Ma Jin's capabilities as a mixed doubles pair, but it's quite obvious that this pair, Jiang Nan and Zhao Yunlei, love playing against their opponents. They've got the game to beat them.
They have the game to beat them, but somehow it's just incredible that it's 16-2. You know, if I was Ma Jin or Xu Chen, I would sit down and think very hard on what's going wrong and what they need to do in order to see if they can win a world title here.
Well, that's very nice.
Because I think they are definitely capable. They played a very good match yesterday against the Danes.
It's interesting looking at Xu Chen and Ma Jin's career history as far as finals are concerned, 24, and they've only won 9. This is their 25th.
Mm.
And that's not a good ratio of win-loss in finals, is it?
No, it's not.
What I haven't researched is the number of times they lost to their opponents of today in the final.
In the final, yeah, I was thinking that, but But the amount of research you've done, you know, hats off. It's amazing. Absolutely amazing. We've had so many things to talk about, and you have set it up very nicely for us.
A complete miss hit. I think that strings went in his racket, didn't they?
It did. He hit the top of the racket.
Well, Kang Nan just pointing skyward, which I perceive Morton as trying to influence the line judge.
Yeah. Yep. All right, if we get it. Oh, we didn't get it.
But he knew it wasn't worth a challenge.
Yeah.
Which is interesting.
There's no point. Or maybe he challenged it.
Or maybe that finger in the air was to challenge it.
And it is called in.
Well, I thought he was trying to influence the line judge. I do beg his pardon.
Yes, absolutely. Do apologise for that. But yeah, already just watching it, it's very obvious why that Xiang Nan and Zhao Yunlei have such a good statistics against Ma Jin and Su Qian. Because when we see Ma Jin and Su Qian play other pairs, they're always on the attack. They're always having this big gun at the back. Su Qian is just blasting smash after smash, and Ma Jin is intercepting. But somehow, Zhao Yunlei and Xiang Nan manage to avoid that. They hardly lift it. They play these small little areas and they keep them under pressure the whole time and never give them an opportunity to attack. So I can see what you said before, that the game just suits them.
Does read the game so well at the front of the court, and you know, I've always believed the two women on court at the moment are, certainly in my opinion, two of the best front court players in world badminton, but at the moment there's one of them that's totally dominant.
And the score says 10-4.
Yeah,
then we don't have to say anything more.
No,
don't mention names. Oh, that's good.
To the mid-game interval. The Olympic champions with a 6-point advantage. Past Morton have won 2 gold medals at the same championships, just 3 men. And of course, we've already mentioned Park Jubong, yes, twice winning the 2 gold medals at the same championships. The only player to achieve that. Last player to win two golds was Gao Ling in Seville in 2001. And she won the women's doubles with Huang Sui, and the mixed doubles with a certain coach that's been here all week, Zhang Jun.
Yes.
Now, unless Xu Chen and Ma Jin can change the momentum of this.
We might add one to the list.
Yeah. Goodness, what defense!
Yeah, that was very cheeky. I think that's another part of the secret. Xiang Nan's and Zhao Yunlei's ability to move Xu Xian on that baseline. See this one here?
Yeah.
But that's the one. Oh, that's hit three or four times, but it looked like that in slow motion. Obviously, it was just one action.
So that's fine.
So it's fine.
Champions last year had an outstanding year. 9 finals from 13 tournaments, winning 6 of them.
But I think we have to mention one thing. Indonesian Open, June this year.
Yeah.
They lost the first round, didn't they?
They did.
To a young Indonesian male player, only 19 years old, and Gracia Poli.
That's right.
They made a major upset in the Indonesian Open, winning that first round.
Sukamuljo was the young male Indonesian you're thinking about.
Thank you. Yeah, well, that was a very, very fine win.
It was incredible, wasn't it?
Yeah.
I said there was one blip this year, and that was it.
Yeah.
It's landed in. That's a very, very good return serve, isn't it?
It is. And then straight down in the center. You can't really play an angle. Look at this. You know, how is he ever going to play an angle on that one?
Yeah. Oh, that's nice. Pushed it long. 9, 15. Oh, goodness. Well, he can certainly give it a powerful hit, but it's no good if it goes wide.
No, but I think this is, again, a psychological thing. You know, he's actually in balance, but he is feeling forced to really go for the lines in order to create the winners because he's up against such a good defense.
Yeah.
See, once again, Su Qian has moved.
Well, we have had our real concerns about Xu Chen earlier in the year, didn't we, Morten?
Yes, we did.
With his movement and his fitness levels, but he's played well and looked good throughout these championships so far.
He has. Really put it to rest for a while, I think. But we have been very concerned in the past 6 months or so.
Yeah. Well, I think this is one of the partnerships that I know we were discussing during the women's doubles whether partnerships were going to be changed in preparation for Olympic qualifying periods. And I do wonder about the longevity of Xu Chen in the mixed doubles playing with Ma Jin. I think Ma Jin at the age of 26 has still real possibilities of Olympic medals.
Absolutely.
And they will want that. But whether Xu Chen
is part of that picture.
Yeah. I have my doubts.
Yes, me too. But interesting, though, who they would partner Ma Jin up with, because I agree with you, Ma Jin definitely need a good partner. She's having an ability to win medals for China in the Olympics.
Yeah, what will be interesting, whether it's just in the mixed doubles discipline or whether she'll be playing women's doubles as well.
That's an option. Definitely, that's an option.
Former world number one in women's doubles with Wang Xiao Li.
Yep.
Two men cut out of the game at the moment.
Playing half court women's singles.
11-18.
Obviously we will not get it in the replay here, but I can understand why Su Qian is sometimes getting quite frustrated. There was a point in the rally where Xiang Nan really had to be stretched and had to lift it from the net, and he was on his way back. He opted not to go for that, but to play the Sao Yunlei, and she just picked it up so beautifully and then played a good counter-attacking shot, and then that was it. You know, what should you do? He's playing his best shot ever and is just completely taken away from him.
Yeah. The former world champions now just 2 points away from the opening game. When they won their world title in London in 2011, they beat the British combination of Chris Adcock and Imogen Bankia.
Yeah, you had to emphasise the British.
Yeah.
Because Adcock is from England and Bankia is from Scotland. Yeah, that was a bit of a fairy tale run the two British players had in London.
Yeah, it was incredible, wasn't it?
It was.
20, game point, 11.
And then I remember the final, we were watching it together, commentating on it, and it completely fizzled out.
Yeah, it was a shame, wasn't it?
Yeah.
But here we have game point opportunities for the Olympic champions, 9 of them. attack. Oh, she's pushing it wide. Lift is long, and at the second time of asking, Zhang Nan and Zhao Yunlei, the number one seeds, take the opening game 21-12. And of course, because there's two Chinese pairs contesting this final, the Chinese coaching staff have left the players to their own devices.
Gone on holiday, gone fishing. Isn't that what you say?
Yeah.
Gone fishing.
Gone fishing. They'll be sitting somewhere in the crowd.
Yes, they will.
Very smugly watching this. Why not?
Yeah, of course, they know all the insights. That's actually sometimes very interesting and funny when you're a coach and you have two players or two pairs of your own playing one another, and you know all the insights to it, and you know, oh, this one hates this and this one hates that, and you know, you really have a chuckle now and again. I'm telling you, it's so funny.
That was a double hit, wasn't it?
Yeah, but in one action,
which is perfectly legal. Does have a very short grip, doesn't she?
She has.
Second game.
But her defense is really good.
Play.
Very, very good.
So the former world champions are one game away from regaining their world title. And the problem, Morton, for Xu Chen and Ma Jin is to somehow say to themselves, or not say them to themselves, oh no, here we go again.
Yes. And they obviously also train on a day-to-day basis.
Yeah.
Against one another, so there's probably also a lot of statistics on that adding on to it.
Return of serve, giving the net cord.
Oh, what a defense. I saw Yunlei here. We get that in slow motion. The first one, that was a bit of a save. But all in vain. That one there, really well played.
It's gone wide. It was a nice idea.
It was. Thank you.
Look how far across Xu Chen in his defensive stance, trying to help his partner out and leaving a huge gap down his forehand side.
Yeah.
He's got to trust his partner. You've just been talking about how good Ma Jin's defense is.
Yes, I agree.
Yeah, it's clever. Once again, nicely spoke, Xu Chen getting in his partner's way. Overcrowding her a little.
Yeah, making sure they get an indecision there.
Wide.
Yeah, try to look at the reaction of first now Yunlei. Oh, we don't get it. How could you miss that one?
Well, she's allowed to do that with her partner because they have a relationship off court as well. Know each other very well indeed. He thought about hitting it.
He did.
Oh, good judgment in the end. My goodness me.
Just about an inch.
Here's another one of my little factoids. Morton, odd man out again. Yes. One player on court. World Championship record.
Yeah, okay. I have Xiangnan has not won even doubles.
Correct. Well done.
Yes. I'm in here, yes.
All the other players have won medals in level doubles as well as mixed doubles.
Yeah. Thank you. I got one of them.
No, yes. stepping into that nicely, but one wonders what on earth Zhao Yunlei was thinking about or trying to do with, or maybe she couldn't do anything with it, this one.
Yeah.
Or was it just far too loose?
This is one of these typical shots which I call desperation in the terms of trying to keep the attack. She knows she's under pressure. She knows that, okay, there's only one option, that's to lift it, but she's opting to play one of these half-court shots and hoping she would get away with it, but she didn't. Lift it.
Oh. Well, that's a good rally. By Zhu Chen and Ma Jin.
7-9.
Nice, well played from Ma Jin.
Yeah, that's the style we normally see Ma Jin and Zhu Chen play. A little bit more confidence into their game.
Chen at the back. I know it's desperately difficult and you have to be awfully careful when doing it, but it certainly does pay dividends. No serve is short.
11-9.
Therefore, the number one seeds have a 2-point advantage over the number two seeds here in the mid-game interval of game number two. Minutes into the match. Quite clear who the boss is in that partnership.
Always been. Always been.
That was a clever one. What a good rally. Oh, it was going well wide.
It was.
But it hit Zhao Yunlei. And therefore it's a fault and the point to Zhu Chen and Ma Jin. Just couldn't get herself out of the way in time. Back level.
11-4. 12, 11.
Yeah, that's a good smash from Zhu Chen.
12, all.
Oh, that's landed well in. Lost his spatial awareness there for a moment, Zhu Chen.
Yeah, that wasn't even close.
Well, there's a challenge here from Zhang Nan. They've only got one challenge left. They've already challenged once, and their challenge was incorrect, but they're challenging again. Once again, it's on the back line. Oh, no, that's out, isn't it?
It is.
That's another wasted challenge. Looking up at the giant screen, looking very anxious indeed, Xiao Yunlei.
13 all.
Good call, line judge. Confirmed by Hawkeye.
No challenges remaining. That's over. 13-all.
What a backhand. That's extraordinary.
Yeah, but that's what we know he's capable of, and we did not see that 14, at all in the first game. 13. And suddenly here in the second game, they're really heating up. And Xiang Nan and Xiao Yunlei really have to watch out. Yes. Not losing this second game, and then the match is wide open again, I think.
Yeah.
So... comes very important.
Yeah, first time in either game that they've been in front.
Yep.
Look at the passion and desire.
Flick serve.
Oh, she just missed it.
Yep.
But that's a lovely idea. That's what you were talking about, moving Xu Chen at the back.
Yes. Yeah, that's the whole idea. And I think that's how Yunlei was really desperately unlucky not to win that one. Suddenly trailing by 3 points.
Go! Make that four.
17, 13.
That is superb. That's a lovely, lovely shot from Zhang Nan. Well, we didn't see it, but I can tell you that Zhu Chen was awfully slow to get up again there.
He's okay.
Yeah.
as you know, we agree that I commentate on injuries and possible injuries.
No, I can't look.
No.
I just wince.
Very understandable. You've been through some very tough times on that. Know what it feels like.
The short lift in the end, miss hit from margin.
15-17.
She does stand committed to that forehand defence, doesn't she? Sometimes
just play it on the backhand side.
Yeah.
But obviously she's standing quite close to the line, so you have to watch out that it's not going out. So it's obviously he's going for power and not so much placement in the hope that the power in itself is enough. Not to go too close to the line.
16-17.
Well, well, well. Margin saying I wasn't ready. Well, I thought she was ready, and so did the umpire.
And so did the umpire.
Yep, and I think that is very, very good umpiring from Jakob Sindberg of Denmark. Look, she's waiting ready. Then she says, no, I'm not. No, she was ready, in my opinion. Also in the umpire's opinion.
Absolutely.
Yeah. 16-17. Well, that wasn't even close. Good return. Just brushing over the shuttle. She won't stop and say, I'm not ready again, will she? Well, she shouldn't do.
No, that would be not so clever.
And
that was the same outcome.
18, yeah. Back level, the Olympic champions.
That return of serve.
Good smash, flatter smash that time from Zhang Nan. And Ma Jin, after
19-18.
Stopping on the return of serve, has not quite been all there. So 2 points away now, the Olympic champions from a second world title to add to the one won in 2011. Oh, that was going wide.
Twice. First one was going wide as well.
19 all. Far from over yet.
19 all.
Brilliant interception from Zhao Yunlei. The double Olympic champion is on the verge of becoming the double world champion. Already won gold in women's doubles in our first final this afternoon. Match point opportunity.
Yeah,
Oh, service fault is called on match point. Struck above the waist.
When you consider how many times that is called a fault, that was a chance to take.
So 20 all, and we require extra points until there's two clear points between the two pairs. So having just saved a match point, now Xu Chen and Ma Jin have a game point opportunity to send this to a third and deciding game.
Taken by Xu Chen, that first one there, yes, is well in. No reason to challenge that one.
21 all. Second game point opportunity for the number two seeds.
Pressure. It's good by Zhao Yunlei.
It's gone long. And Zhang Lang and Zhao Yunlei don't have any challenges left, so they can't challenge that one. It is one game all, having been match point down. Now the number two seeds, Xu Chen and Ma Jin, are forcing a third and deciding game in this mixed doubles final. It is one game.
先不要拿他，他自己中间就可以。50 minutes。放了一堆，等拿他从中间嘛，他也跟我。你那是不是就是square吗？太打我这玩意儿没用。放。要不要我有？谢谢。对吧？那别着急。
Umpire calls 20 seconds, a change of shirt for Zhang Nan. And they appeared to be cruising at one stage. A game and 9-4 up. And somehow, Xu Chen and Ma Jin have battled their way back. It's Five one game eight. All. Nicely done by Ma Jin. And again. My goodness me, this final suddenly has a very different feel about it. Double hits by the Olympic champions. Well, this is nigh on the perfect start. One of the silver medalists from a year ago. The role of the two women in this last final this afternoon is going to be paramount importance. It's only the sixth time that it's gone the full distance between these two pairs. That overwhelming statistic, Morton, of 16 and 2.
Yeah, almost 17 and 1.
Almost 17 as 1, yes, absolutely. Yeah. With that, one of those victories when the Olympic champions, as they are now, retired injured.
Feeling as I say, Ma Jin and Xu Chen is really warming up now. They're getting into it. They played not the best the first games, I think, and their opponents really completely dominated that game. But from the middle of the second game, they really came back and they played well. And now 5-3 up in the third and deciding game. I think we see a change here. I see they're a lot more aggressive and they play much, much better than what they played in the first game.
Yeah. I mean, as I said just a moment ago, I mean, at a game and 9-4 up, I thought the Olympic champions were on cruise control.
Yes.
And maybe that was what the problem was, yep. That they didn't keep the intensity and that just allowed their opponents back into it.
Mm. Yeah. If they don't win this one, I'm sure they will kick themselves for that.
One match point opportunity. in the second game. Oh, that's well wide.
Yes.
I can see what he was trying to do, though.
Yes, you're right. It's very nice to see that some of the returns, there is some variation to it. They're pushing them into those deep corners as well and not just playing the net all the time.
Mm.
And I like to see that, and I think that was a good effort.
Well wide. Serve.
Yes, our Yunlei is really a good server. I've noticed the whole tournament, obviously, also other tournaments than this. She's a very, very good server. Partner Xiang Nan is a little bit more suspect in that department.
Defense.
Yeah, what a shot.
Oh, yes. Eventually pulled out of position, Xu Chen and Ma Jin. Seven of the last 8 points to the Olympic champions. Indication that they've found their intensity, up their pace again. Surely they won't make the same mistake of just taking the foot off the pedal.
I don't think. It's very hard to say. On it's going, you know, one side and then the other side is up and it's down, and suddenly one of the pairs is playing really well and you think, okay, now they got it, and then it's completely reversed. 2 minutes later they make not the most clever shots and some horrendous mistakes now and again, and then, you know, it's back to all back to square one again.
Yeah,
it's very, very difficult to call this one.
8-10.
Emphasizing your point. Here we are again.
Yeah.
1 point in it.
10-7 up. Suddenly 9-10 again.
Well taken by Jan Nan.
That was, on the other hand, extremely well played.
Yeah. So a 2-point advantage.
That's good.
Mm. Yu, Zhang Nan and Zhao Yunlei, the number one seeds, had a 2-point advantage at the game interval in the second game, and they failed to convert. 1 hour and 1 minute. Formation. That's better. 11-9, deciding game. Oh, terrible indecision between Xu Chen and Ma Jin. And it should have really been Xu Chen, surely, Morton.
Yes, there's no reason for indecision here at all.
He should go back and play that.
He should. It's textbook.
Going wide. Well, they've
no more challenges.
They've spent all their challenges. But, of course, the umpire could have overruled. Ooh, and I think perhaps should have overruled. But in all honesty, the umpire is only allowed to overrule if he sees a clear error has been made. Now, I think that, ooh, that was clearly in. Well, that, in my opinion, is why we need more challenges. Two per game. Because always in sport, you want the fair and correct outcome of these officiating decisions. Should be the battle of the athletes rather than whether an official has got it right or wrong.
Absolutely, I couldn't agree with you more. But I have to say that I don't think that Xiang Nan and Zhao Yunlei has used their challenges very well.
No, they haven't.
So, you know, they are penalised for not using and not thinking carefully enough.
Yeah. So, good point.
You know, it goes two ways. You have to take that into consideration.
Well played.
Once again, a wonderful serve by Zhao Yunlei. Good defense here.
Yeah. We talked about that earlier, didn't we? That Ma Jin goes nearer and nearer to that line with the forehand defense.
Yes.
And the winning shot played on her backhand side.
And that's enough.
Yep.
The placement in itself is enough. It's So is this the decisive lead? Come on, friend.
No, well, I thought that is the second game when they had a 5-point advantage.
I'm just teasing you. We never know what's happening here.
No. Oh, that's a good shot. Yeah. There's a real intensity now about the Olympic champions.
16-11.
5-point cushion.
And good for the Olympic champions. It's Zhao Yunlei serving and pointed out on many occasions earlier. Her serve is really awesome. She is serving so well.
Hello.
11. Yeah. Now I'm beginning to feel an inevitability about this.
But not before now.
But not before now. No, no, I haven't.
No, no, I agree with you. It's been impossible to call this one.
18-11.
That is unbelievable. What a smash from Xu Chen. My goodness me.
12-18.
That's a good shot from Marjin, wasn't it?
It was, that push down the line there. And now the cross is coming.
Phenomenal.
There's still an awful lot of catching up to do for Marjin and Xu Chen.
Low serve is short. That is costly.
That's not the way to do it.
No. 2 points away from their second world title. Zhang Nan and Zhao Yunlei. Desperately needs a good serve here, Marjin. Oh, string's gone in the racket.
Yeah, what a time. What a time for that to happen.
And now it is 7. Match point opportunities. 7 opportunities for Zhang Nan and Zhao Yunlei to regain the title that they won in London in 2011. Yeah, this time It was, in fact, their second match point opportunity, because they had a match point in the second game. And the Olympic champions, Zhang Nan and Zhao Yunlei, win a second world title. Well, my goodness me, they were made to work hard for that. 21-12, 21-23, 21-13 in the deciding game, an hour and 12 minutes. Umpire confirming the score. Well, Chuchen and Marjin for a second consecutive world championships have to settle for second best.
The prize ceremony will begin shortly, and we ask you to stay and greet the winners and all medalists. Thank you.
Well, this is the match point, the world championship point. Put away very fittingly by Zhao Yunlei. Becomes only the eighth player in world championship history to win two gold medals at the same world championships. She did it at the London Olympic Games, first player ever to win two Olympic gold medals in the same games. And now has finished off a wonderful day as far as she is concerned, having won gold in the first final of the day with Tianqing, the women's doubles. In fact, that women's doubles was the shortest final of the day at 54 minutes.
I believe that.
So we're just about ready for the prize presentation. And quickly, Morten, before the two finalists make their way to the podium. I mean, what a day it has been. Women's singles, outstanding to me.
Outstanding. But, you know, coming into this finals day, personally, I thought, to be very honest, oh, this can go horribly wrong. You know, we will have hardly any fights and all that because there's so many favourites here. And in the men's doubles, the favourites lost. In the men's singles, the favourite lost. And in the women's singles, the favourite lost.
And women's doubles, the favourites lost.
And the favourite. But that was closer.
That, yeah, well, yeah, yeah. I appreciate that.
Yeah. But that's amazing, isn't it?
Bronze,
yeah.
From China, Liu Cheng and Bao Yijin.
Liu Cheng and Bao Yijin. World Junior Champions in Guadalajara, in Mexico in 2010. Bronze medalists here at the World Championships. The European champions, the Olympic bronze medalists, Joachim Fischer-Nielsen and Christina Pedersen, pick up a second World Championship bronze medal to add to the one they won 5 years ago in Hyderabad in India. For Chuchen and Marjin, well, they were beaten finalists a year ago. It's a third world championship medal as a pair. Two silvers and one bronze now.
21-12, 21-23, 21-13. From China, Zhang Nan Zhao Yunlei.
A second world championship for Zhang Nan and Zhao Yunlei. Gold in 2011. A bronze last year in Guangzhou, and gold once again here in Copenhagen.
And this is the new president of the Danish Badminton Association, Mr. Toft, who is presenting the medals.
Eighth world championship medal for Zhao Yunlei, a third gold. For Marjin, a sixth world championship medal. And a fourth for Zhu Chen, my goodness me. Isn't that telling? Been so successful over recent years, the gold and silver medalists we will see a lot more of this young Chinese pair, Liu Cheng and Bao Yixin. Beat the number four seeds, Mr. and Mrs. Adcock from England in the third round. And I wonder how many more major championships we will see Joachim Fischer-Nielsen and Christina Pedersen standing on the podium. Joachim Fischer, of course, at the age of 35, maybe time limited for him. Most outstanding pair consistently, Zhang Nan and Zhao Yunlei, over the last few years. 11 finals, 8 finals in 2011, winning them all. 9 finals in 2013. And here, now 4 finals in 2014, winning a third time.
It's Niels Nygaard, who is the president of the National Olympic Committee here in Denmark, handing over these special vases.
Scots, the medals.
Hardly hold it all.
Well, for Denmark, we have these medals at these championships, but for a third time on finals day, the national anthem of the People's Republic of China. What a finals day it has been. Five tremendous matches, thrilling badminton. And it is, as I said just now, a third bronze medal for Denmark. They've hosted the World Championships 4 times. They've medaled in every time they've hosted the World Championships.
Yes, I think Denmark can be very happy with 3 medals. Obviously, they would have liked to have someone in the finals today, but 3 medals it was, and I think they are very happy with that.
Yes, of course, Victor Axelsen in the men's singles, Boa Mogensen in the men's doubles, and now Joachim Fischer and Christina Pedersen in the mixed doubles. But 3 titles today for China in the women's doubles, the men's singles and the mixed doubles as well. The all-Korean men's doubles final guaranteed a 4th gold medal for Korea in the men's doubles discipline, but it wasn't the pair that we thought was going to win. We're going to get a quick word with the world champions, Camilla Martin, who of course won the women's singles here in Copenhagen in 1999, beating Dai Yun in that women's singles final. She's trying to grab the winners. And here we are.
Congratulations. Gold medal number two today. What was the difference today? Why did you win?
先祝贺你一天之内赢得两枚金牌，你觉得这两枚金牌对你来说意义有什么不一样吗？
我觉得没想过这么多吧，我觉得今天对我来说非常幸运，非常开心，拿到两枚金牌，我的队友也发挥得很好吧，我今天觉得非常幸运。
I don't really think that much. I just feel lucky and happy, and my partner also play a good game, so I'm pleasant. Yeah.
How is it to play with your girlfriend on court? Is she the boss?
你觉得跟女朋友一起打球感觉如何？是你主导她还是她主导你呢？
首先，这种关系非常，非常不好说吧。然后，相互之间可能更多的是相互沟通吧，因为可能遇到的困难会很多。但我希望两个人可以一起努力，一起朝着两个人共同的梦想吧去努力。
It's hard to describe this kind of feeling, but I think what's important is the communication between us, and we would like if we can fight together for a better tomorrow.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. And very nicely said. Jiang Nang.
Yeah, that was one of the better answers, wasn't it?
Yeah, super. Well, it has, as I was saying earlier, Morton, been an extraordinary finals day here, hasn't it? A new star has been born, the European champion, Carolina Marin, becoming the world champion. What a sensational result. Who would have, predicted that?
A week ago.
Yes. Heartache, of course, for Lee Chong Wei on Malaysia Independence Day, his third consecutive world championship final, his third consecutive defeat. My heart goes out to him, but all credit to Chen Long, who played so well today.
He did. All credit.
And in the men's doubles, well, the world number ones, Lee Yongdae and Yu Young Sun, well beaten by their teammates Go Sung Kyung and Shin Baek Chul. And I think there was a little bit of rivalry there because of former partnerships and partnerships being swapped around. But it has been a fantastic championships here as the mixed doubles champions pose for the photographers and for fans. Alike. That, of course, means that the World Championships have been concluded. The 21st World Championships. From all of us here, we can reflect on today's finals. Three of the finals going the full distance. Not that any of them were a foregone conclusion. The first one, the quickest at 54 minutes, an hour and 20 minutes for the men's doubles. That was a sensational match. And the story of Carolina Marin, the European champion, winning the women's singles for Li Shuerei, the Olympic champion, a second defeat in two consecutive world championships. But that doesn't compare to Lee Chong Wei, a third consecutive silver medal for him. But Chen Long, he gave a performance to be very proud of. And Zhang Nang and Zhao Yunlei, for Zhao Yunlei, a second gold medal of these world championships, becoming only the eighth player in history to achieve that. It has been a wonderful week in Copenhagen. We've thoroughly enjoyed it. Thanks for your company from all of us here, from Morten Frost and myself, Jill Clark. Until the next time, bye-bye.
Thank you.